This is Dereck Robinson, and this is for my finance 301 class. I'm going to be giving a financial analysis on three companies. I chose Harnback, Offshore, Lowe's, and Lockheed Martin. I'm going to give you a brief insight on some of these companies. Harnback Offshore is one of the leading providers of marine transportation services to exploration and production oil field services. Offshore construction and military consumers. Lowe's, founded in 1946, traded on the New York Stock Exchange since 1961. Lowe's has grown from a small hardware store to a home improvement company, providing customers inspiration and support whenever and wherever they shop. Lockheed Martin, founded in 1912 by both Alan and Malcolm Lockheed. Both brothers are talented mechanics who set up shop out of their garages, constructing seaplanes that would shatter speed and distance records for overwater flights. Today, I'm going to talk about short-term solvency, which is the ability to pay bills in the short run. It's also the measure of liquidity. Long-term solvency, which is the ability to meet long-term obligations and financial leverage. Asset management is intensity and efficiency of asset use. Profitability and market value is how the market views the business. First, I want to make a 6-month loan to one of these companies and I have to pick one. What falls under short-term solvency, I'm going to talk about the quick ratio, cash ratio, and current ratio. Let's start with the current ratio, which is cash, current assets over current liabilities. Current ratio is mainly used to give an idea of the company's ability to pay back their short-term liabilities with their short-term assets. During the past 3 years, Harnback Offshore Services' highest current ratio was 4.08 and the lowest was 2.29. An example of this would be Harnback at its highest of 4.08 and current assets for every $1 of current liabilities. Lowe's highest current ratio of the last 3 years was 8.37 and its lowest was 5.92. Lockheed Martin current ratios, Lockheed Martin current ratio's highest was 9.87 and its lowest was 7.97. Next, we will take a look at the quick ratio, which is current assets minus inventory divided by current liabilities. Quick ratio is more conservative than current because it excludes inventory from assets. Inventory generally takes time to be converted into cash, and if inventory has to be sold quickly, the company may have to accept a lower price than the book value for the inventories. Harnback shows signs of low inventory because their quick ratio has barely changed from their current. The highest in the last 3 years was 9.05 and lowest was 4.74. Lows also have very little change in the current to quick ratios. The highest was 2.93 and lowest was 2.17. Lockheed Martin appears to have a high level of inventory compared to the other two companies. There is a significant difference between the quick and current ratio. Over the past 3 years, its highest was 13.25 and its lowest was 8.80. The last liquidity ratio I will discuss today is cash ratio, which is cash divided by current liabilities. Cash ratio is a measure of the company's liquidity. It can determine how quickly a company can pay its short-term debt. Lockheed seems to have more liquid than the other two companies. Its highest is 8.37 and lowest is 7.97. Lowe's appears to have higher liquidity than Harnback at its highest of 7.09 and lowest of 5.92. For the short-term loans, I rank the companies from 1 through 3, one being the company I'll give the loan to and 3 being the least more likely company I'll give the loan to. Lockheed because it was more liquid than the other two companies, Lowe's because it was a little more liquid than Harnback. For my 5-year loan, I use the equity multiplier times interest earning ratio for my own long-term solvency. Equity multiplier is the total assets divided by total equity. It's the measure of the company's financial leverage for the use of debt to acquire additional assets. Harnback, for the last 2 years, the highest equity multiplier was 0.48 and the lowest was 0.45. Lowe's highest equity multiplier was 0.45 and lowest was 0.34. Equity multiplier for Lockheed Martin, the highest was 0.11 and the lowest was 0.06. Now we're going to look at the time interest earn ratio, which is the measures of portion amount or income. Hornbeck's highest was 3.35 and his lowest was 1.26. Lowe's highest tier was a 1.27 and his lowest was 1.29. Lockheed Martin highest was a 1.90 and lowest was 69.3. I rank these companies the same way from 1 to 3, where is number 1 is which company I would give the loan to. I chose Lowe's at 1, Lockheed at 2, and Hornbeck at 3. Last, I'm going to talk about investing 50% into a company. I'm going to look at profitability, asset management, and market value ratios, which is here. Profit margin, which is net income divided by sales, which shows how much profit for every dollar in each sale. Hornbeck highs in the past 3 years was 46.73 and the lowest was 7.66. As far as return on equity, which is the measure of the stock quarters fair through the year, net income divided by total equity, the highest for Hornbeck is 9.05 and its lowest was -0.27. Return on assets, which is the measure of profit from dollars in assets, Hornbeck highest was 4.07 and its lowest was -0.13. Market value ratio can be determined as price per share divided by earnings per share. Lowe's highest profit margin was 33.10 and its lowest was 13.13. Its return on equity was, his highest was 44.84 and its lowest was 13.86. The return on assets for Lowe's was the highest at 17.77 and the low at 7.0. Last company, Lockheed. Profit margin for Lockheed, its highest was at 10.22 and its lowest was 9.53. The return on equity for Lockheed was high at 27.52 and the low at 21.77. Return on assets for Lockheed was 16.29, the lowest at 14.25. I rank these companies like the ones before on a scale from 1 to 3. 1 being the company I'll give the loan to. I chose Lockheed Martin because they were more asset efficient companies and more asset in return. Thank you.